everyone, welcome back to Farming Simulator 22. Today we are on a new map, Monette Farms. This is based off of farms up in Canada. They also have farms in the United States. We also have a new Dodge Bighorn semi-tractor to show you guys, and a pull-behind Case International combine. See, I was out here testing it out earlier. That small path there. This is one of the starting equipment, 9250 Case International Combine. Let's get this set up for the next row here and then go over to the farm. Alright, we're over at the main farm here. The main starting equipment. Got headers and grain carts, cultivators. A couple semi-trucks set up with trailers already. Got the B-train set up. I think I'll show you guys the Dodge Bighorn tractor. This is by Chris Dahl. Did a really nice job on this. He let me test it out. Show you guys. You got different options in here, actually different engines. Let's see, we got Detroit Diesel 60 series, Cummins 855 Big Cam, Cat 3406C, Cummins ISX 15. Different rim options. I think I just went with the standard. Yeah, you got Dayton rims and the Alcola rims. The different color options. He's actually got some of the old colors in here, which is nice. I think I choose the old blue. Different interior options, colors, even carpet, seats, door panels, the whole works. You even got color options for engines. He's got this set up for a 13 speed. Even got working gauges, speedometer. Oh, his warning buzzer that first comes on when you start the truck up. See, that setup is you can see it over there. Fuller Road Ranger RTO 9513. This has got high-low range. It also, you notice in the upper gears where the shift lever doesn't move, that's actually where you split the gears so the shifter is correct. In case somebody wonders, we got it in low there. There's second, third, fourth, fifth. Now sixth gear. That's where you start, where it starts splitting the gears. So the next shift up, you actually won't So you want to actually see the shifter move there up to 7th. 8th. 9th, that's where you'd split it again. 10th. You actually see the clutch move between the shifts. Nice sounding engine brake. I'm gonna turn around here. I like the 13 speed, that's what I'm used to mostly. There we're in the top hole. Just holds on there. Oh, we gotta shift down, we're almost ready to turn here. We got our driveway coming up. Got our grain bin set up here. Actually, I have more that's set up for an auger, but we'll start unloading them here. We'll go over to the field, show you the what else we have. We got the 1586 hooked up to the 1682 Case International pull behind combine. This is by Redline Modding. He converted it over. I believe it was JCL Farm Equipment that had it in Farming Simulator 19, he said. Here's where I'm going to show you how to change your horsepower on a, you got a 1486 V8 that could use a little more horse for pulling this. But I'll show you guys what the 1586, how that handles it. So this is a working speed of 6 miles an hour, the header. I had a 1466 hooked up on here, but I thought, well, we'll do a little bit more power comparison with the 1486. Said the 1468 is actually a V8, so it should have a little bit more horsepower than the 1586, actually, or really close. Let's see how it pulls it. No problem. Good. We got our 1468 here. We'll go up there, get our grain unloaded, and then we'll switch them. The 1466 I had it on here for around the combine earlier, testing it out. There we go. I think we'll unhook it here. This had to turn manual attach off so the combine hooks up the way it's supposed to. But I find that's not uncommon. Also too, this has a manual. I might show you guys how to actually switch it to a automatic. We'll see how it does here. We already have our header down. Yep. Well, yeah, it's not even pulling it. Barely. Oops, I didn't want to do that. For some reason, when you press the down button, it actually folds out more, but that actually even bogs it down more. Turn the header up. There, it can pull it. And that's just pretty much on the flat. It pulls around fine, but as soon as you kick the PTO in, it says, no, I'm not going. Even try to do it on the fly here. Yeah, she's just crawling. All right, so I'll show you guys quick how to change the horsepower settings, even speed. So I have our mod extracted out here. We'll go right into MX file, XML file. Should say, go down to your engine settings. Well, you'll see up here where it has the max speed, 40 miles an hour. It should have the horsepower. That's like the advertising for the store data. We'll go down. It's usually underneath the tire configurations. Okay, here's where we have our horsepower. So, okay, you can see here they got torque scale set at 0.374. That's pretty low. You want to calculate out what 145 horsepower would be. You would actually take your calculator, take 145 horse times 0.00434, and you get a torque scale of 0.6293. So that's about half of what the actual horsepower is. We can put the real horsepower in there and see what it does. Change this to, what's it? 0.6293. We'll go just those three digits. Round it up to 0.630. I always like to keep the three digits after that. I always like to put the three digits in there just to be safe, just to make sure the game doesn't act up. It might not, but that's how I like to play it safe anyway. So you have your max forward speed. That's actually kilometers. So if you're going to figure out, let's say you want it 20 miles an hour, you actually go 20 times 1.609, and we got 32, so that's actually, we can divide that out. What's 40 divided by 1.609? It's for like 24, close to 25 miles an hour. We'll leave it set there. Same with the backward speed. All that's in kilometers. Like I said, just take it by. If you can't reach your speed, if it's still low, you can actually change the RPMs. That will actually increase your horsepower some too. But that's a lot better than changing your, let's say, your gear ratio. But then you'll find out you'll need more horsepower to do the same job. So I just leave that alone. All right, so we'll save that. Close it out. And we'll want to copy our old file name. We're going to send these to compressed file. Let's paste back in what we had. We're going to put this back in our mods folder. Overwrite what we had there. All right, we're back. We'll try this out, see if it made an improvement. Oh yeah, big improvement. I'm liking this pull behind combine too. Thank you, Redline Modding, for converting that over. Now we got the 1468 that actually pulls it. I will try to do another video at least with changing transmissions. Try to put a manual tranny in here. I think that's gonna have to do it for this time, guys. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.